go and be nice to people and try and help people along the way, and I die without, and I die and God's not real. What have I lost? I asked him. And he thought about it for a moment. He says, well, I suppose you've lost nothing, aren't I? I said, but see, if I'm right and you're wrong, you're bait. Because we're all going to find out one way or the other. Appointed once for man to die. Consider your ways. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. The message has never changed.
That's right. Never.
Repent.
Never. Never change.
Repent means change your mind. Change the course of your life. Stop and think about what you're doing. Many wrong choices have you made, people. We've all made them. And you go along and you make them. And you know, the same insanity is this. They keep doing the same thing and getting the same results and not change it. We all need Jesus Christ. We all need the grace of God.
Hallelujah.
There's not a person who doesn't need it. We all need it.
Bless you. Have a lovely day.
We're in a land that's full of religion.
Glory to God.
People grew up, you've heard the gospel, you've gone to church, you've gone to mosque, you've heard about Jesus Christ and how he died on the cross.
Yes, amen.
And yet we reject what we hear.
Hallelujah. That's right.
It says, you know,
amen.
In Isaiah 53, he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised
for our iniquities.
The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed.
Amen.
Now this is written 750 years around about approximately.
Yes.
It was a prophecy. But listen to how he goes on. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way, and the Lord has
laid on him the iniquity
of us all. You know, people say the Romans killed Jesus. Others will say it was the Pharisees that killed Jesus. But listen to what the prophet says.
Yep.
He said, it pleased the Lord to bruise him. It pleased God. And I am asking you to think about what you're doing. Because God did give a son. And God did allow him to be whipped and beaten and scourged and nailed to Calvary's tree. So why would you reject such a gift? You can't buy a gift. Can't earn a gift. It's been extended out to you.
That's right.
All you have to do is
receive the gift.
Of eternal life.
Hallelujah.
There may be a backslider walking down here. There may be someone who walked that way. I tell you, I backslidden. I was the most depressed person on the planet. And if you're backslidden, I would ask you to consider your ways. People will judge and they'll mock. And their self-righteousness as if they're something holy. Listen, when we stand before God, he'll not ask him what I was doing. He'll ask you what you were doing. So think about your ways, people, today. Don't die without Jesus Christ. Don't die without accepting him as your Lord and Savior. We have seen miracles. Back in 2008, the servant Pastor Brian had seen deaf ears open. Cancer open, healed. Even metal disappeared out of a guy's leg. He's got the x-rays to prove it. Who but God can do such things? Who but God can take metal out of someone's leg and make it disappear? We have seen the power of the Almighty. If you look around you, if you look at the trees, if you look at the birds of the air, God spoke these things into being. How can you say there is no God? You know, God says you're without excuse, for creation itself proves that there's a creator. God created trees to produce oxygen, and they have a seed within themselves to reproduce themselves. How can you say that happened by chance? Even food that we eat, it's in the ground. No one invented food, it was just there for us. It has a seed within itself to reproduce, even male and female. They reproduce after their own kind. Listen to me, there is a God, there's a creator. You can see, you can hear, you can walk. You've got these thin teeth at the front for ripping and big molars at the back that chew your food up. And then even the body, how can you look at the body and say it's just a freak accident? It's created. Look at the organs all working together. What makes your heart pump from the day you're born to the day you die? And it pumps and it pumps and it keeps you alive, pumping blood around. How can you say that happened by chance, people? You need to wake up. The end is coming. We have nuclear weapons now. We have weapons will kill billions of people if a war breaks out. Can you not see we're heading toward the end? Can you not see with the plagues that's coming upon the planet? Can you not see with the floods and the earthquakes are more frequent? Just watch the news, you'll see prophecy being fulfilled before your very eyes, people. Consider your ways. Repent, for the kingdom of God is surely at hand. One day you will stand before a God, and you may live your life and you may say, I'm happy. See, people don't go to hell because they're sinners. People go to hell because they love their sin, and they don't want to give it up. They enjoy it so much. If I was a Christian, I'd have to give that up. If you could only see what God wanted to do with your life, if you could only see He created you for a purpose, just like a bee, if you think about a wee bee, it cross-pollinates and it flies about in the earth here as in the summer. But God created such a creature. And if you were to take all the bees out of the planet today, and you would kill every bee, within 3 months, every living, existing thing would die, including us. Now that's a big purpose for a bee. How big's the purpose, God's purpose for your life? You're not a mistake.
No.
God knit you together in your mother's womb. You are fearfully and you are wonderfully made in His image. Can you not see it? Have you ever seen a dead body? I'm sure we've all been at funerals. And we knew these people when they were alive and they were running about, jumping about, they were full of life. But in that coffin, and we all go by the same way, they're nothing but an empty shell. See, you can't see your soul. It's not a thing that you can see. It's an eternal thing. When God made Adam in the garden, He was just made of dust. He formed him and He molded him. He spoke everything into being, but He took His time with Adam and He made him in His image, molded him and shaped him. But he was just like a dead body. He was lifeless. And it said, God breathed life into His nostrils. We all came from God, and we all need to return to God, because our sin has separated us.
Yes,
we're separated from our God because of our sin, because of our rebellion.
Yes.
But God so loved the world.
Amen.
That He gave a son for you.
Amen.
That's like you go into court and you're guilty and you know you're guilty. The judge knows you're guilty and everyone knows you're guilty. And Jesus steps in and He doesn't know you. And He goes, Your Honor, we all know He's guilty. But let Him go, let her go. I'll die in her place. Why would you reject such a loving gift? For God so loved you, my friend. And the message is the same. Please rethink about your ways. Consider what you're doing. If you died today, I ask you, where would you spend eternity? Because one thing's for sure, we're all going to find out one way or the other. I tell many people when I speak to them, you can spend a lifetime looking into the gospel of Jesus Christ. But listen to me, or you can spend an eternity in hell wishing you had him.
Jesus.
Repent.
Jesus.
Repent.
Jesus.
Repent. We beg thee, we beseech thee. Oh Lord, would you give them ears to hear? Would you give them an understanding? Would you help them to see clearly? Eternity is in front of you. Where will you spend it? May the Lord bless this message. And may He give you conviction that leads to conversion.
Hallelujah.
You know, the prophet Isaiah said this, seek the Lord while He may be found, while you breath in your mouth. Because if you die, it's too late.
That's right.
Seek Him while He may be found. Call upon Him while He is near.
Yes, amen.
And He will freely pardon you.
Amen.
If you ask Jesus Christ, there's no fancy words. And if you're listening to me, I would say to you, when you're alone tonight, cry out from your heart, Jesus, forgive me of all my sin and fill me with the Holy Ghost.
Yes,
and you will be born in the Spirit. Your name will be written in the Lamb's Book of Life.
Yes.
I think of the story in Luke chapter 16. And it talks about a rich young ruler. And I always wondered to myself when I thought about it the last couple of days, why his name was not Manson, because Manson's another guy's name. The beggar who sat at his door, Lazarus. And then I thought, And it says in Revelation where Jesus said, and I will not blot your name out of the book of life.
Yes.
See, he wasn't mentioned because his name was not written in heaven. He wasn't known in heaven, but Lazarus was. And this guy, if you read the story in Luke 16, all of a sudden this dead guy's burning in hell and torment, and he's crying out, he's an evangelist now. He wants to tell everybody, oh, go back and tell my family. Go back and tell my family, lest they also come to this place of torment. I'm telling you, people, eternity is looming. You have a void, you have an emptiness, and I would say, consider your ways. Repent while you have breath in your mouth. Call upon the Lord while he is near, and he will surely pardon.
Bless God, you, God bless. Bless you. Oh, we're on fire today, aren't we? Keep our lip. Keep our lip. I'm telling you. We're on fire. Got a bit of music on. Booty.
I've got one.
Size of
him. My goodness, what a feed
them. It's over
2
size
of a bud.
Yeah.
When I look at a Vara, Vara's only...
She's
a bit deep. Oh goodness. Every Tuesday.
Good.
Used to come on a Monday, but on the Tuesday.
Get much of a good response,
but... Oh, aye.
Good.
I always get the odd ones when I argue.
Churches?
No church at all. In different places.
Oh, are they? No, I thought maybe it was the Elam or...
No. It's just all different. Them two over there, they're converted Roman Catholics. And then that guy, Smishanka, and he's from the east. Hanak goes to a black church in the centre of the town.
They're all a wee dancer.
Oh, I spend all police money.
I'm ready.
Did that give you his card?
I'm ready to kill him.
Are you?
I'm ready to call
him. Good to see you, Christy. See you later. Hello. Yes, Stuart. Not so bad, mate. Not so bad. Is it? All right. It was Gavin didn't come in with a retainer, that's right. Yes. Right. I know, it's always the same. He had a job before he went in, you see, so he did and he didn't survive. You know, he's working, but what I'll do is I'll tie up with him and try and work through the wee book. I've got printed the wee program, you know. So, yes. I know what you mean, yep, yep. Okay, thanks, Stuart. I'll see him when he gets back. Okay, thank you. Okay, God bless you, Stuart. Thanks for letting me know about it.